for corruption to take place, you have to have several parties and business not being clean. And there's been a whole range of things happening. You know, so for me, a key part is acknowledging that nobody is in the sort of on high ground. And, you know, it's shoulders to the wheel for everybody. We'll have to stand together to move forward. And everybody will have to change and make their contribution. I, to a very large extent, agree with what Nick has said here. There is no quick fix. I mean, there are quick fix to fill a hole here and there. But by and large, the journey to get onto where we need to be, to grow the economy so that we do create jobs, is not an easy one. And the insidious cancer that we have, on the one hand, is the corruption, but that is, to my mind, a quick fix. The big issue is, how do we get education going? How do we turn people away from what we've done in the past to what the challenge of the future will be? No use looking back all the time. And, you know, I have a lot of experience with that doing insurance. It's like dealing with, they tell you an actuary sits on the back seat of a car and tries to give you directions by looking backwards, you know. That is not the solution. We have to fix what is coming. And to my mind, it's the big trends that we have to. If you look at the winners of the past 10 years and, 20 years, and it's people who focused on this emerging middle class, you know. If you really look at it, the ShopRites, the Capitecs, a whole range of businesses, Sunlam and others, who were able to harness the big trend that is going there. That isn't just a fad, but it's a long-term trend. Those people will win. People who tried to do quick things and so successful for a year or so and didn't make it. And then, unfortunately, the latter half of, you know, the last 5-6 years is the state captures who were successful. And so, and fortunately, we'll see their demise now. But the trick is, what will win, and so forth. And the only winner in the long term is really education of people. From a business perspective, it's harnessing things like, you know, urbanization, which is a trend that we can't return. Those people who get to grips with what is happening there, and around that, they will win.